This series of videos will explore the basic grammar of the Romance languages by comparing and contrasting Late Latin and its descendants. This first video is a short introduction providing some general thoughts before we just jump right in. The Roman Empire spread Latin as it conquered its way throughout ancient Europe. Local popular forms of Latin, collectively called Vulgar Latin, developed over the centuries, changing, as languages do, into a variety of languages and dialects across the continent. Some of these languages even spread across the globe and continue to develop far from their original homes. Nowadays, there are five major Romance languages: French, Spanish, Portuguese, Italian, and Romanian. Those are probably names you recognize. But there are other regional languages like Sicilian and Catalan, and extinct languages like Dalmatian that give us a more complete picture of this language family. So what is a comparative grammar of the Romance languages? Very briefly, a grammar is how a language works. So a Romance grammar will tell you, or give you an idea of how the Romance languages work. This grammar will be comparative because instead of just looking at individual languages like just French or only Spanish, we'll explore examples from multiple languages in each topic. Throughout this series, I'm going to display examples on your screen. Vulgar Latin examples will start with an asterisk. That little star is going to tell you that Vulgar Latin words are reconstructed. They come from a mostly undocumented form of Latin. If you want to learn how extinct, undocumented languages are reconstructed, I share a lot more in a separate series covering the basics of historical linguistics. I'll put a link to that below. Here's one example. Classical Latin writers used loquor for I speak, but some late Latin speakers started saying parabolo, and others started saying fabulo for I speak instead. Examples in languages other than Latin, in the modern Romance languages, start with an asterisk when they offer negative evidence. Negative examples are reasonable structures that tend not to show up in a language. For example, English speakers say my language, but don't really say the my language. Well, in Italian, the opposite is actually true. But don't take my word for these, really. You can get a taste of the frequency of any of these examples by starting to search for similar structures online. Positive examples should come up a lot more frequently than negative ones, if the negative even returns any results at all. Okay, let's divide Romance words up. We'll split them up based on whether or not each word has different forms. In English, the word hat has a plural form, hats. These kinds of words are variable. Other words, like to and to a party, are invariable. In the Romance languages, content words like nouns and verbs can vary, while function words like prepositions and conjunctions tend not to vary. So how do variable words vary? Not in any old way. Variable words vary in a very specific way. They have a base that carries the meaning, like this Spanish base, función. We call this base a stem. Endings attach to the end of this stem, and often carry some grammatical information. That Spanish stem, función, can be used in the verb funciona. It works.
Funciona.
It worked, and so on. We'll treat these variations as different forms of the same word, not as completely different words. Let's build on these ideas in upcoming lessons as we start to look into how nouns, verbs, pronouns, adjectives and adverbs, particles, and sentences work in the Romance languages. I'm really excited to start sharing some examples with you. You're going to meet some very cool languages and get a good sense for how this family works. Balete, That's goodbye for now, and I look forward to next time.